blessed be the tie that binds our hearts in Christian love. The fellowship of kindred minds is like to that above. These were the words of John Fawcett in a time when he understood the bond in Jesus Christ was greater than that of possessions. It was the 1700s. John Fawcett was the pastor of Waynesgate Baptist Church in West Yorkshire, England. The Yorkshire countryside was very beautiful, though it had few people and would often appear barren and cold. This setting would bring many challenges amongst the good-hearted and hard-working people of this region. John Fawcett, his wife, and four children had no home to call their own. Instead, they stayed with different parishioners of their community. As a minister, he was paid a meager £2 per year. The people of the community would show their love to him by gifts of wool and potatoes. Yet, this living was not foreign to Mr. Fawcett. He was orphaned at the age of 12, and within a year he became an indentured servant. At the age of 15, while standing in an outdoor crowd of more than 20,000 people, he heard the famous George Whitefield preach. This was a moment that changed his life forever. Now, years later, after pastoring for 7 years in Yorkshire at Waynesgate Church, Mr. Fawcett received an invitation in 1772 to go to Carter's Lane Baptist Church in London to replace the renowned Dr. Gill. This family was full of excitement. In London, their living conditions would improve drastically. London would have good schools, would have libraries, large churches, and more Christian fellowship. In excitement, the family lost little time in packing. They were packed and on their wagon, waving farewell to the people who had come for miles to say goodbye to this family. His wife turned and asked, "John, do you think we are doing the right thing?" John Fawcett knew that he could not leave, and he turned the horses around and stayed for another 45 years. Soon after, he wrote the words to the hymn, "Blest be the tie that binds." This hymn has been a treasure to many Christians facing separation. God's word says in Matthew chapter 6 and verse number 33, "But seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you." The true measure of the quality of life is not found in the world's possessions, but a relationship with Jesus Christ that binds people together.